excited.
Oh, I am too.
Yay.
I'm thrilled. Thank you for having me.
And Plow and Hearth is a name that you know my family adores.
Yes.
And this is something that is the best of both worlds because it is from the amazing Plow and Hearth name that's been around since 1980, bringing us the best of the best for decor. But this is functional because fruit flies and gnats have no place in our kitchens, Nancy.
Absolutely, they do not.
Nancy brings us these creative ideas all the time, and so we're thrilled to welcome her to the In the Kitchen with Mary family.
Yay!
So how does this, not only does it look beautiful, what does it do?
So it's going to, in a beautiful way, take care of those fruit flies that everybody faces. You know, we get the fruit from the grocery store, from our gardens, from the farmer's market, and then you come in the kitchen and you see the fruit flies. They are all over the place. There's very unsightly ways to get rid of them, right? But how about having something that's really beautiful sitting on your counter for that time when you know you need to get rid of them? And they're super easy to use. They come with the recipe for the solution that goes inside. It's like the secret sauce that draws the fruit flies into here. And you probably have the items in your kitchen. It's a it's one part apple cider vinegar, one part water, and a little squirt of liquid dish soap. And you're going to put this in here. You're going to set this on your counter, and then the fruit flies are going to come here.
I just can't believe how gorgeous they are.
They're beautiful.
I love that they're working hard for us.
Yes.
But we do have all five color choices available. So I was showing you the purple first and foremost. For those of you that love a little purple accent, we don't always get our accessories in purple.
I know, it's true.
Purple is still available. Oh my gosh, I'm in love with this one. Looks like a party, right?
It
so totally, funny. This is multi. And that's where you're getting those blues and aquas and oranges and creams all the way around. Now, right directly in front, that's orange. Chris Prime from Lock and Lock. Orange is her favorite color. So we do have the orange available. It looks like that Murano glass. It's so beautiful. Then right here in the back, we have your blue. This is where you're getting shades of blue, some lighter, some lightest, and then some of those darker cobalts too, and a little bit of glittery bronze. A
little bit of glittery. That almost looks like druzy quartz.
Yes. Then green, last but not least, is our most limited color choice. And that's where you're really getting the color of the season there with that regrowth and that beautiful richness of the front lawn that hopefully we'll have this year. We didn't have much green in our lawn. But this is $18.24. We have two easy payments of $9.12 for you. But here's a little animation to show you what's happening. This is what we're talking about here.
So like I mentioned, you're going to take one part apple cider vinegar, one part water, and a squirt of liquid dish soap. I usually use about a tablespoon and a tablespoon. You are not filling this all the way up. You're only putting about a tablespoon in there. You're going to tip your fruit fly glass, your fruit fly sideways by take off that stopper, and then you're just going to fill that reservoir. And then Mary, do you see that little volcano down there? That's where the fruit flies are going to go up in. They're going to smell this like secret sauce that's in there, and they're going to be drawn to it. Now you have to remember to put away the fruit that's been ripening on your counter, run your garbage disposal, clean out your garbage can, because you don't want them drawn to that. You want them to come to the fruit fly trap and then the solution that's down inside here. So they're going to go up inside here, and then it's going to be hiding the fact that you're getting rid of fruit flies. So you don't have something unsightly on your counter. You have something beautiful, and yet it's taking care of that problem that we all face.
Got it. I love the fact that when the light hits it too, there's going to be a lot of pretty mosaic colors on the side. But this is such a great point. You're adding the liquid to the top, and anytime that you feel like, okay, it's been a little while, you just pour it out, rinse it out, and start over.
Exactly. Maybe about two or three, probably 3 days, set it out on the counter, and then, you know, if you have a problem that's kind of continuing, like you said, just rinse it out, and then you're going to pour a little bit more in, and you're going to be pouring it in the top, and then the fruit flies are going to come up inside this hole that's in the bottom. That reservoir is in there, and that's created by that kind of volcano that's in there.
Got it, yes.
So only about a tablespoon is necessary in there, because fruit flies are little. They don't need a lot, you know. You're going to have that scent that's going to be drawing them. They're drawn to the scent of kind of like over ripening fruit.
Okay.
So that's why the apple cider vinegar works. And when you put that in there and set this out on your counter, it's going to be drawing the fruit flies in there, so you're not seeing the problem.
I mean, look right back here. So I know that it's about 6¾ inches high and about 4 inches wide. And if you think, ooh, okay, so I'm going to be trapping little buggies with it. Is it going to look pretty in my kitchen? Watch this. I'm going to walk right back here. Take a look right up there with your mugs. I mean, no matter which color choice you're picking up, would anybody take a look at that and think,
is that your bug zapper?
Right. I mean, nobody, this is a piece of artwork in your kitchen, and it is glass.
It is, it's blown glass. So it is, it's artistic glass, and it's something that just looks gorgeous on your counter, even before you need to use it as a fruit fly trap, and after you use it as a fruit fly trap, you have something that's just really pretty sitting out there, and no one will know when you are using it as a fruit fly trap that that's what you're doing.
Right by the fruits and veggies, because we don't have it in an aerated bowl. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's gonna ferment pretty quickly. It's gonna turn.
Yeah.
So take a look. Does that look like a little bug catcher in your kitchen?
Nope.
No. That's why Plow and Hearth is so good at what they do.
Plow and Hearth is just this great company that gives you all kinds of wonderful things to help you add, you know, kind of special touches to your home. And they created these fruit fly traps because they, like the rest of us, love fresh fruits and vegetables. And yet, the other solution that people do is have that clear glass with plastic wrap on it with holes punched in it, and they sit it on their counter.
Yeah.
Well, then you're seeing the solution to the problem. It's not very attractive. So how about having something that's beautiful, that is functional, and I love when Plow and Hearth takes functional and turns it into fabulous.
I do too. You know what? This is the purple color choice for you. The one that I had by the fruit basket, this is multi. Then directly in front of that, we have the orange. This is your blue. Blue is most popular, and we also have green. Is green? Green is still most limited, and we have 400 remaining. By the way, 400 have been ordered and in the kitchen with Mary today, and we have two easy payments of $9.12. This fits in perfectly with what we're going to be discussing in our after show today for In the Kitchen with Mary, because we're talking about how to reduce frustration, how to clean up the kitchen a little bit better, but reducing the chemical footprint in the kitchen while we do so.
That's so great.
This is such a perfect way to do it.
It is. This is a non-toxic way. You know, you might have pets or small children in your home and you don't want to use chemicals. You want to have something that you're going to use that is on the ready. And that's what I love about this. It's so pretty. You get it home right now, put it on your counter. It's beautiful. And then when that trouble comes, you know, we all face it. You're going to be able to put this out and take care of the problem. So it's one part apple cider vinegar, one part water. So tablespoon, squirt of liquid dish soap. Take the stopper off, tip it sideways, and you're going to only have about a tablespoon or so in that reservoir that's at the bottom. Put this out on your counter, and then the fruit flies are drawn to this. Make sure you're getting rid of that bowl of fruit, or eat it, or put it in the refrigerator so that they're drawn to the trap. And then that's going to take care of it. They're going to get caught in there, and you're not going to have to see that. You're not going to have something that is unsightly. It's just a beautiful piece of art glass that's sitting on your counter, but helping you take care of a problem.
Nancy said before the show, if you don't have any of those ingredients, you can put a little red wine in there and then they'll go out happy.
Yes, that's true.
Which I thought was fantastic. So we have two easy payments here of $9.12. Already 600 have now been ordered in the Kitchen with Mary. So my friend, because it is your first In the Kitchen with Mary, will you come play a game with
us? I sure
will.
The show?
Yay!
Anything to stay longer.
So continue to place your
yes.
But it's time to play what?